Hi, I'm Dr. Deepa Agarwal. I'm a consultant nutritionist in the city and I have my clinic in Secunderabad as well as in Hyderabad. Now, the topic of today's discussion is whether teenagers should take vitamin supplements. If so, how it should be done. Frankly speaking, when it comes to vitamin supplements are only provided when a person is found to be deficient, because supplement means you have to take something additional away from your food. Now, if you are a person or a teenage who takes a balanced diet, for example, you eat all your three major meals like breakfast, lunch and dinner, you are eating your mid-morning snack properly, your lunch, your snack, evening tea time snack adequately, and then your bedtime option also adequately, most of them do not land up into deficiencies. But then there are cases or teenagers who come to us with some sort of deficiencies. It can be a vitamin deficiency, it can be a mineral deficiency. For example, if I come across a girl who's not been eating well and she has her irregular menstrual cycle, heavy bleeding and all, and she lands up into iron deficiency, then we have to give them iron supplements and correct it, because we know if there is iron deficiency severe in the body, then there might be chances wherein the person might have fatigueness, tiredness, fainting episodes and all. So we need to correct them by giving supplements, because by diet it will take time to correct it, though the correction can be made, but then supplements is where it is required. Now this is an example of an iron deficiency case. Now there are children who do not absorb B12 properly in the body. B12 is nothing but a B complex vitamin. Now because of the gut insensitivity or because of the type of food that they eat, the absorption is poor, and B complex we know is a water soluble vitamin, it is not stored in your body, so we need to give them supplements of it, otherwise they'll get into again anemic states and all. So we give them B12 supplements along with their diet. Now they are again teenagers who have severe, you know, deficiency of either zinc sometimes, or they have deficiency of calcium in their body. So we need to identify their serum values of these micronutrients or vitamins and minerals, and then supplement it accordingly. Now there is always a word of caution when we use vitamin and mineral supplements, because most of them are stored in your body except vitamin B and C, which is water soluble. All other vitamins like A, D, E and K, they are stored in your body. So if you are giving supplements, make sure you are giving in par with the values what you have seen in the blood report, and only give them for a particular time frame. Once the correction has been done, you should review that person and try to stop them, otherwise the person will land up into toxicity of these micronutrients or vitamins and minerals. So it's always advisable, check the blood value, check their dietary pattern, see their lifestyle, give them a diet along with the supplements, review the person and try to taper down the supplements, so, and give them again a diet which is more nutritious with all those supplements, so that they are not getting deficiency of those micronutrients again.